Assalamu alaikum, everybody good morning. Welcome back to our online class. This is Shahadat Hussain Litton, a state teacher in English of Bachapura High School, Sundarganj, Gaibandha. Dear learners, hope that you are well at home. I am also well by the grace of Almighty Allah. Dear learners, in this epidemic period, coronavirus, whereas all body should have stayed at home. That is why, dear learners, in this consistently, I am in front of you with a new lesson. Dear learners, before starting my lesson, I would like to say something about my previous video. Dear learners, do you have any question? Do you have any question? Any problems? Just like this representation, sound system, etc. You will comment me in my comment box. Dear learners, today I am going to discuss about transformation of sentence. Dear learners, this topic is very, very important for the students of class 6. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, even were the students of degree past course and honors compulsory English. Dear learners, this is the main fact, this is the main terms, is and everybody listen to me and to look at the board. First of all, today's topic is transformation sentence. First of all, we have to know that what is transformation? What is the definition of transformation? Dear learners, first of all, we have to know about this. Transformations means, dear learners, listen to me, try to understand, pay attention to this. Transformations means when we transform a sentence from one structure to another structure, one structure to another structure, without changing its meaning, without changing its meaning, dear learners, try to understand, without changing its meaning, it is called transformation. Then, dear learners, for your better understanding, once again I repeat it. When we transform a sentence from one structure to another structure without changing its meaning, it is called transformation. Okay, dear learners, I hope that everybody have understood. Now, already according to the topics, already I have detailed out some grammatical items. Everybody look at the board. Number one, degree, active to passive, affirmative to negative, assertive to interrogative, assertive to exclamatory, last of all, simple complex compound. Dear learners, first of all, I am going to discuss about degree. Okay, now let's get started. Dear learners, before describing about degree, we have to know, we should know about the worldness levels, because these are related on topics. So, I am going to discuss about world and level. Dear learners, first of all, world. Dear learners, can you tell me what do you mean by word, or what is the definition of word? Yes, word. Word is a letter. Word is a letter or group of letters. Group of letters. Word is a letter or group of letters expressing
expressing a meaning. Okay, dear learners, please try to understand. For your better understandings, once again I repeat it, the definition of word. Word is a letter or group of letters expressing a meaning. Just like this, I am showing you examples. A, M, D, girl, boy, pen, etc. Dear learners, A, 100% you know, A, here A is a letter. There is no doubt about it. So, word may be a letter or it may be group of letters. Just like this, A, M, D, girl, boy, pen. A is a letter, but girl is a group of letters. So, word may be, word is a letters or group of letters that expressing a meaning. Okay, dear learners, now let's get started. Syllable. Previously, I told you syllable. Here is a question. Dear learners, anybody can you tell me what do you mean by syllables? I mean, what is the definition of syllable? Yes, syllable. Syllable is a part of word. Syllable is a part of word which is pronounced in a single thrust of breath. Dear learners, please try to understand. Syllable is a part of word. It is not a complete word. Just part of word. Syllable is a part of word which is pronounced in a single thrust of breath. Thrust of breath. Okay, dear learners. I hope that you have understood. Do you have any questions or any complaint? You will comment me in my comment box so that I can give you a solution. Okay, dear learners. Now, if I ask a question, how many kinds of syllable? Do you know how many kinds of syllable? Okay, dear learners. I have to erase it. Stay with me. Okay, dear learners. I have to ask a question. How many kinds of syllable? Yes. Everybody look at the board and try to understand. Syllable. How many kinds of syllable? Dear learners, according to English grammar, syllable is of four kinds. One, two, three, four. Dear learners, syllable is of four kinds. Such as monosyllable, disyllable. Trisyllable, last of all, polysyllable. Okay, dear learners. Syllable is of four kinds: monosyllable, disyllable, trisyllable, polysyllable. But here is a question: what do you mean by polysyllable? I mean, what is the definition of polysyllable? Okay. First of all, here it is monosyllable. So I have to discuss what is the definitions of monosyllable.
Okay, dear learners, look at the word monosyllable. Monosyllable.
Monosyllable. Yes, monosyllable.
Monosyllable. Monosyllable. Monosyllable.
Monosyllable. Dear learners, monosyllable. A word with one syllable.
A word with one syllable.
A word with one syllable. It is called monosyllable. A word with one syllable. Please try to understand. It is called monosyllable.
I am showing example. Look at the board. Such as man, cow, boy, pen, etc.
Okay, dear learners. I hope that you have understood. A monosyllable, a word with one syllable, that is its symbol, which is pronounced in single, it is called monosyllable, just like this, man, cow, boy, pen, etc. Okay, dear learners, now next number,
dissyllable.
Okay, dear learners, just like this, a word with two syllables.
A word with two syllables. Two syllables.
It is called dissyllable. I'm showing examples. Okay, try to understand. Dear learners,
examples, two syllables. Two syllable examples.
Man, just here is monosyllable, but O man. Dear learners, a word with two syllables, one syllable equal two syllable. I mean O man. Everybody clear? Okay, dear learners. Now next number, trisyllable. Okay, stay with me.
Trisyllable.
Just like this, previous a word
with three syllables,
a word with three syllables, it is called trisyllable. Okay, I am showing example. Trisyllable. You have to think that about a word with consisting trisyllable. Okay, just like this, beautiful. 1, 2, 3. Everybody clear? Equal beautiful. I hope that each and everybody, I want to understand it. Now next number. Now let's talk last of all, polysyllable.
Yes.
Check like this. In the same way.
A word with four syllables.
A word with four syllables is called polysyllable. Okay, dear students.
I am showing example. Look at the board and try to understand examples. It should be polysyllable. And just an example. Interesting. Interesting. Dear student, please try to understand. Interesting. It is consist in four syllables. That is, it is called polysyllable. I mean, a word with four syllable, it is called polysyllable. Such as interesting equal interesting. Okay, everybody clear? Okay, dear learners, already have completed discussions about syllables and word. Now come to the main point. Transformations, those are topics related to transformations, one of them degree. Now I am going to discuss about degree. Listen everybody, stay with me and try to understand. Okay, dear learners, stay with me and try to understand. Don't be subconscious minded. Just try to understand. Okay, now I am going to discuss about degree. First of all, degree means completion of adjective. First of all, I could discuss that what do you mean by degree? What is the definition of degree? Oh yes, completion of degree. Completion of degree. Yes, completion of degrees. Sorry, completion of adjectives are called degree. Completion of adjective are called degree. Okay, dear student. Anybody girl, can you tell me how many kinds of degree? How many kinds of degree? Ladies and gentlemen, Vithi, can you tell me how many kinds of degree? Yes. According to English grammar, degree is divided into three parts. I mean, degree is divided into three parts. That is, degrees of three kinds. Okay, dear learners, first of all, positive degree. You know, positive degree. Next number, comparative degree. Comparative degree. Last about superlative degree. Superlative degree. Okay, dear student, you know, degree is an adjective. Adjectives are three forms, you know. Number one, suppose, okay, dear learners, degree, positive, positive, comparative, superlative. Here, positive, comparative, superlative. Okay, dear learners, if we want to understand completely, you have to know about these forms of adjective. Number one, good. Good. What will be the comparative form of good? Yes. Good. The comparative form of good, better. Good, better, best. Dear learners, next number, bad. 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 What is the meaning of bad? Yes. You know, it's synonym word ugly. Bad, worst. Bad, worst. Okay, next number, smallest. Just like this, big, bigger,
biggest. Dwellers active, more active, most active. Most active, beautiful, more beautiful, most beautiful. Intelligent, intelligent, more intelligent, most intelligent. Okay, dear learners, this is ICT, you know. You have to know about these forms, about the forms, good, better, best, bad, good. First, smallest, smaller, smallest, big, bigger, biggest, active, more active, most active, beautiful, more beautiful, most beautiful, intelligent, more intelligent, most intelligent, suspension. In the same way, important, more important, most important, tall, taller, tallest, fat, fatter, fattest, old, older, oldest. In the same way, you can do. Okay, dear learners. Now I am going to discuss. Discuss how to convert into positive to comparative, comparative to superlative. Dear learners, this is the main fact of topics. Each and everybody try to understand. Don't be subconscious minded. Dear learners, already I have told you how to convert into positive to comparative, comparative to superlative. Okay, dear learners, let's get started. Each and everybody take your khata with a pen and start writing with me. Okay, dear learners, rule number one. What will be the structure of superlative form? Subject, superlative, SUP, superlative, subject plus verb. Plus subject plus verb plus the plus D3 plus noun. Here in for noun, it will not be a nanu. Dear learners, remember it. In for here, noun. D3, do you understand? D3 means here? Yes, good. Good, better, best. Good, better, best. Yes. This is positive form, it will be short form.